Hey guys, welcome to another episode about my e46 320i with an m54 engine. In this video I am going to refresh almost the entire cooling circuit. I am going to change the water pump, the cup, the expansion tank, the thermostat, the radiator and a couple of hoses. Well, before starting removing the parts, I have decided to perform a pressure test. I am pretty sure that my car is not losing any coolant, but by performing this test I will be 1000% sure.
Well, the manual says that you have to apply a pressure of 1.5 bar and you have to wait about 2 minutes, and the pressure should not drop by more than 0.1 bar.
If you have a pressure drop, so you have a leakage that you have to find it. If you don't find any, so maybe it is internal inside the engine. In this case, it could be the head gasket.
Minute left.
See now. So 2 minutes left, and we can conclude that there is no pressure drop on the circuit and everything is okay. Then I've started removing the airbox, the fan, and the belts. A water pump bearing was shot. Removing the water pump pulley. By removing the screws, the pulley should fall off, but in my case it was stuck. I've tried with a pulley extractor, but it was too short. Then I gave up, I forgot about that pulley, and I want to do something else. To drain the coolant, there is 2 screws, one is on the radiator and the other one is on the expansion tank. Removing the expansion tank cap helps draining the coolant much more faster. Now disconnecting the hoses. I've tried removing the expansion tank alone, but I couldn't, so I've tried to remove the whole assembly together. There is 2 screws holding the assembly on the radiator, one on the bottom and the other one is on the top. Another coolant hose should be disconnected also. To get more room, you have to disconnect the cooling hose of the alternator. Disconnecting the temperature sensor at the outlet of the radiator. Disconnecting the outlet hose of the radiator. Now, tackling the thermostat. The engine hook should be loose so you can remove the thermostat. Back to the water pump pulley, I've pried with a big screwdriver and it worked just fine. Now unscrewing the water pump. Luckily, there is two threaded hose on the water pump that helps removing it from the engine. At the beginning, I have used short screws, but it didn't work, so I have switched them with longer ones and it worked just fine. These are the thermostat screws, by the way. This is still the original pump actually, after 200,000 kilometers and the impeller still looks like new, but it is time to replace it. The bearing was shot anyway. Time to drain the engine block, there is a big screw that should be removed. I have prepared a kind of protection to avoid the spread of the coolant all over the place. And of course that washer should be replaced. Then I removed the radiator, but unfortunately I lost the rest of the footage. Now, this step is optional and not necessary at all. I have decided to remove the heater control valve to clean it, because this kind of valve likes to stuck in a position open and closed. I will not show the details on this video here, and opening and cleaning the heater control valve will be a separate video. I have used hose clamps to stop the coolant from draining. Removing the expansion tank from the holder. Here I was just checking if the new expansion tank fits correctly on the holder. The new expansion tank came with a new level sensor which was already installed. Nice. reinstalling the heater control valve. Replacing the aluminium washer of the drain plug of the engine block. Then refitting the drain plug of the engine block. A little bit of cleaning of the thermostat and the water pump areas. This is a new water pump. It comes with a gasket.
Wait. There we go. Silicone spray. Everything for the stuff. And that's it. Let's install it back in place.
For the tightening torques, please refer to the description of this video.
Now, let's install the thermostat now. That's kind of easy. It's like straightforward work. Normally, you don't need to use RTV sealants. Time to clean up this pulley a little bit. This is the water pump pulley actually. Let's use some BD40. That's it.
Pay attention to the rectangular shape of the hose. They are not equidistant. Remove the plastic trim from the old radiator because we're gonna need it. It holds the fan actually.
Why is it like this? I install a backpack one.
Installing the expansion tank holder. now fitting everything back together. Fitting the new temperature sensor on the new hose.
Now let's install the hose back in place.
Time to refill the coolant, remove the bleeding screw. Set the heater at the highest temperature and the blower at the lowest speed.
Now for the coolant, I am going to use the Liqui Moly stuff. As you can see here, the proportion will be 50-50%, 50% coolant, 50% water. So this car needs 8.5 liters of coolant. Now we have 4 liters of coolant.
For a good bleeding of the circuit, the coolant should flow from the bleeding screw without bubbles.
I think now there is no bubbles. Screw the drain plug back.
Very important, any excess of coolant should be eliminated.
Everything looks to be okay. And we'll keep the engine running till the thermostat open up and let the engine cool down and check the level again.
And that's it. In the next video, I will be playing with a heater control valve. In another video, I will be cooking on my garage. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. See you next time.